I honestly didn't find any other fellow language learner sharing their experience with Indonesian. Should I be scared? I don't know. Hey everyone, welcome to my channel. I'm Margherita, a language teacher and polyglot to be. Since 2020, since COVID basically, my passion for languages has grown a lot and I've been studying a few of them, namely English, Portuguese, Latin, Spanish, Mandarin Chinese, yeah, and that's it. So I'm not a novice with language learning in general, and I'm a language teacher myself, so I know some tricks of the trade, but Indonesian is honestly something completely different. I decided to study it because now I live in Australia, in Western Australia, and it's very close to Indonesia. And it's also very common to go there on holiday, especially to go to Bali. And in August last year, my partner and I decided to follow this trend and to go to Bali for my first time ever as an adult. And yeah, I thought, what a perfect moment to start learning Indonesian.
We bought the flights for Bali. I'm so happy. We're gonna go there like in the end of September for the last two weeks, 10 days of September.
I didn't have any specific goals. I just wanted to see how much Indonesian I could learn in 1 month-ish.
Now what I want to do is to challenge myself to learn as much Indonesian as possible, as much as Bahasa as possible, before going there.
I hadn't even started studying it when I encountered my first struggles. It was honestly very difficult to find enough and diverse material on the internet, and especially on YouTube. From what I found, apparently there are only 2 YouTube channels teaching Indonesian, and I couldn't find any other fellow language learner sharing their experience with Indonesian. It was also difficult to find PDFs and websites online, as well as a good reference book. Pretty strange, because Indonesian is spoken by a lot of people, and I guess it's also studied by many, or apparently not really. I don't know, pretty strange though, right? So at the end, my main resources were an Indonesian book for Italian speakers, Babbel, even though I'm not too satisfied with the Indonesian course on Babbel, and YouTube.
So today is the 30th of August. I'm gonna listen to a video. Hati hati dengan orang yang jahat.
Be careful of bad people.
Hati hati dengan orang yang jahat.
Hati hati.
Right from the start, I was fascinated by this language that's pretty different from the languages that I already knew. But I also felt that it was an exciting challenge, because the grammar doesn't seem to be too difficult. I mean, my mother tongue, my native language is Italian, and Italian, like all the other Romance languages, has a pretty articulated grammar, right? With lots of verb conjugations and exceptions. You shouldn't find all this in Indonesian, from what I've seen. But the vocab was and still is completely disconnected from the languages I spoke.
So today is the 24th of August, and today is my third day studying Indonesian. And for today, there's some Babbel planned. I think I'll just do a couple of lessons maybe, and I will for sure review, because I already forgot the majority of the words.
So after this month-ish of studying Indonesian, I didn't feel prepared at all to go to Bali, to go to Indonesian and speak with the locals. Like, zero meno. But now I can say I'm very happy, because I feel like I've interacted in a more meaningful way with the locals, just because of my sincere curiosity in their language and culture. And it was so good being able to say or even just understand one single word in Bahasa.
Hello, hi. Selamat malam.
Malam, yeah.
Wow. How is beautiful in Bahasa?
Oh, cantik.
Sorry?
Cantik.
Cantik?
Yes.
Cantik. Banyak cantik.
Cantik sekali. It's different.
Okay. Cantik sekali. Cantik sekali. Okay. Cantik sekali.
Makasih.
Makasih. Yeah.
Terima kasih is is the conflict.
Yeah.
Terima kasih.
Yeah, terima kasih.
Did you say about ibu bapak terima kasih pak?
Oh that yeah.
You okay. Say about the boy.
Okay.
Terima kasih bu, Mrs.
Okay. Thank you for teaching me bahasa.
Oh, thank you. You're welcome.
Thank you so much.
Terima kasih banyak. Selamat tinggal.
Selamat tinggal.
And in my experience, all the locals were pretty excited as well to hear a foreigner trying to speak their own language. That's honestly what I love the most about language learning, which is the connection you can create with people from all around the world. Now that I had this first experience, I feel I'm more prepared to study Bahasa, or at least I hope so. While I was there, while I was in Bali, I bought a significant amount of books for children in Indonesian and English. Recently, I also bought one grammar book and one with some short stories in it. But I'm not too satisfied with the grammar book, with the reference book, because now and then it just drops new words and sentences without giving any explanation. I'm like, what is going on? What is this? So yeah, it's not very thorough. It's not a method that I really enjoy. I would also like to take some private classes, and I really need to take some private classes, but unfortunately I'm super duper picky when it comes to choosing a teacher. So I'm kinda unconsciously postponing this decision. But yeah, sooner or later I will start taking some private classes, because I really need a guidance, you know, I really need a guru. So please, if you have any recommendations, please, please, please share them with me, because I really need your experience and advice. So let me know in the comments, please guys, I count on you. And I'll see you in the next video. Ciao, ciao.